A new tasker is out, and with it comes a glimpse of a much-requested feature, a new UI for Tasker. It's still in a very early stage, but you can try out the new Tasker UI right now by enabling the option in Tasker's preferences. The new UI is more intuitive and expressive, allowing you to drag and drop actions visually so you know exactly where they end up. It's faster, letting you edit and test small changes in your actions without ever leaving the same screen. It's more customizable, offering multiple options to change how it looks. And more powerful, allowing you to use variables in any parameter and even have multiple editors at once. The new Tasker UI follows the Material 3 design guidelines and principles, making it easier on the eyes than the old UI. As mentioned, this is still a very early version of the UI, and many more features are coming, so stay tuned!
Tasker WebUI.
As long as you enable the new WebUI option, Tasker now offers an API that lets you control its UI with simple HTTP requests, meaning that anyone can build a web page that controls Tasker just in the way they like it. I've already built an example web page that allows you to control Tasker's UI from my PC, but anyone can chime in and make it better. Check out the GitHub link in the video description, where together we can make the best Tasker UI ever.
Device owner.
If you go through the admittedly arduous process of making Tasker a device's owner, you will now have access to super powerful actions that you otherwise wouldn't be able to perform. Stuff like killing running apps, disabling apps, setting app permissions, or even uninstalling apps altogether. As a bonus, if you use the custom option, you'll be able to access any of the functions in the Android Owner API.
Set device effects.
Lets you do cool stuff like set your screen to grayscale, dim your wallpaper, and toggle always on display on and off. More effects will come in the future.
Vibration intensity
allows you to customize your notifications with a variety of diverse vibration patterns. How about playing jingle bells with notifications?
Other stuff.
There's a new Get File and Folder Properties action that lets you grab multiple properties from multiple files at once, like name, size, type, date, and more. It even has advanced filters, so you can get only files with certain properties and sort them any way you like. There's also an action to get network data usage, letting you see how much data you've used up on your mobile and Wi-Fi networks. And an array compare action, where you give it two or more arrays, and it shows you exactly what the differences are between them. This and much more in the new Tasker.